My name is Tim O'Donovan and I work with Seedtech in Ireland, and we're a partner in the Lake Humans Translator project. As part of the project, we helped with some research that was carried out in Teagasc and also some research that was done commercially with Adesco in Ireland. So we're going to hear today from Peadar Lawlor from Teagasc and John Ryan from Adesco and their research findings and where Faba beans fit in terms of the animal feed performance aspect. But here in this field, it's a field of links. It was sown in the middle of March. It's a high yielding site. When we go out to this time of the year, we take a look at the number of plants per square metre, we look at the number of pods that are on each plant, we look at the number of beans that are in each pod, and finally we take a weight of the number of the beans. So when we put all that together, that's the components of yield of faba beans. So we have an estimate in this field of approximately 7.5 to 8 tonnes to the hectare. And we'd expect this field then to leave a reasonable profit margin for the grower, but also it produces a high quality animal feed that's native to Ireland and is used in animal feed rations over here, but it also has a benefit from carbon sustainability perspective as well. And I suppose, look, most importantly in terms of the Green Deal and the farm to fork and all of the European rules that are coming up into the future, faba beans have the point of view where they actually formulate their own nitrogen in the roots. So it's a win-win perspective, a win-win crop really for growers in Europe. And I'm joined here today by Dr. Peadar Lawlor of Teagasc, who's a pig nutritionist and has also done research on faba beans in pig diets. So Peadar, you did some research on faba beans in pig diets. How did you get on, or have you any comments about it?
I think faba beans is an excellent ingredient. We have a good bit of work done on faba beans over the last number of years. From a carbon footprinting point of view, there's a huge benefit to using beans, and they're an excellent replacement for soybean in the diet, and they can replace some of the cereal content in the diet.
And in terms of the work you've done some work in 2016, you've done some work in 2020. Do you want to just share us a couple of key points on that, knowing that the technical summary is going to be attached to the video anyway?
Yeah, I suppose the first bit of work that we did was in 2016.
Yeah.
That was where we looked at propionic acid treated beans, and we incorporated that into a diet at 40%, either in raw form or in extruded form.
Okay.
And we found that we got equivalent performance in the pigs compared to a barley wheat soya diet.
Okay.
So we were very happy with that, and the carcass quality and weight, etc., was identical to the cereal-based diet, cereal soya-based diet.
Okay.
Yeah.
And in the current piece of work that you did in 2020 as part of the Lake Humes project, how did the beans perform as a replacement for soya?
That trial was slightly different, Tim, and maybe just to set it up for any listeners, there was three varieties of beans there, Lynx, Victus and Toffin.
Yes.
So look, the Toffin, I suppose, is the one we're most interested in. That was the one that it's a zero tannin variety. It was grown in Germany. The other two varieties were grown here in Ireland.
Yeah. So in terms of pig diets in Ireland, Peadar, and in Europe, where do you see faba beans fitting in?
Okay, Tim. Well, faba beans can replace some or all of the soya in the diet, which is important.
Yes.
But they also take the place of some of the cereals in the diet.
Okay.
And we've fed up to 40% beans in the diet to finisher pigs. And I'd be happy to recommend that people could replace all of the soya in their diets for finisher pigs.
With faba beans?
With faba beans, yeah. When it comes maybe to growers or weaners, maybe I'd be setting a limit maybe around about the 20% in the diet. Simply because, well, and I'd be looking for maybe a low tannin variety there for those type of younger animals.
Okay.
For very small newly weaned pigs or for sows, I wouldn't include beans in those diets. We just don't know enough yet to include those safely. But I'm sure they will be safe in the future.
So Peadar, in terms of treating the beans, is there any different treatments you think would enhance the performance of them?
Yeah, Tim, we fed acid-treated beans in our 2016 trials.
Yeah.
And we got excellent performance with them. We got no reduction in carcass weight.
Yeah.
So it was totally equivalent across the board with a barley wheat soya diet.
Okay.
However, in the 2020 studies, we got some reduction. We got a significant reduction in carcass weight when we fed beans, all of the three varieties, in fact, gave us a reduction in carcass weight.
Okay.
In that trial, we fed dried beans. The
yes.
previous trial was obviously acid treated.
Okay.
So that may be partly the problem. It may also be that in the second trial we used buck values to formulate that particular diet.
Okay, okay.
But I suppose what we need to do is go back and look at dried versus acid treated beans, and that's something we need to do in the future.
Okay, thanks very much, Peadar. And I'm also joined here today by John Ryan of Adesco. And John, you were involved in the project with us here in Legumes Translated. Do you see a place for replacing imported soya with faba beans grown in Ireland or in Europe?
To do, Tim, similar to Peadar, we've done our own commercial feed trials with Kiernan's 800 pigs on a trial, fattening pigs. We only replaced 20% of the soya with 25% of the beans.
Okay.
But they were acid-treated beans. We found a healthier pig. We done the same feed conversion efficiency as the control diet with soya and all that.
Okay.
But what we did find overall was a much healthier pig.
Okay.
We had less condemned carcasses and we had less condemned meat in the total diet.
Okay.
In the total trial. So overall, beans were a very positive replacement, and that wasn't allowing for the carbon. I know there's no measurement or no monetary value on carbon at the moment, but we halved the carbon footprint of the diet by using beans.
Okay.
Which is substantial.
What did your research have to show in terms of sustainability and carbon?
Tim, the idea that we can end up with a green pig, native pig fed on native grown cereals and proteins in Ireland is colossal. Like the fact that we don't have to bring in soya from Brazil or America, and the fact that we all have our own food security within Europe,
okay,
has a huge place to play for the continuity and the sustainability of the pig industry.
Okay. John, thanks very much for your information on that. There's some really good points in that. And I suppose, look, at the end of the project, our aim within Seedtech was to help the industry explore a little bit more on faba beans, their use in pig diets. And we're standing in a field of faba beans here. It's towards the end of August. These are going to be cut for feed within about 4 to 5 weeks. And hopefully they'll be landing in a pig diet in Ireland over the springtime and into the winter.